a bill easing foreign equity restrictions on various industries, now also up for President Duterte's signature. That's as both chambers of Congress ratify the bicameral conference committee report on the proposed amendments to the Public Service Act. The measure will allow 100% full foreign ownership in all economic sectors except public utilities, which includes transmission and distribution of electricity, water pipeline and sewerage, seaports, and public utility vehicles. House Ways and Means Committee Chairman Joey Salceda says nearly 300 billion pesos in increase in foreign direct investments is expected over the next 5 years as a result of the amendments. Lawmakers also say the amendments will be a game changer in liberalizing public services, which will ultimately benefit Filipinos. Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian calls on Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi to resign over the controversial Malampaya deal. In a privileged speech Wednesday, Gatchalian said Cusi and his subordinates are liable for gross neglect of duty and grave misconduct in evaluating and approving the Chevron-Udena deal. He also accused the DOE of giving unwarranted preference to Dennis Oy's firm. Aside from Chevron's, Udena was able to secure another 45% stake in Malampaya after purchasing Shell Exploration's shares last year, bringing its total ownership to 90%. The remaining 10% is maintained by the Philippine National Oil Company Exploration Corporation.
I call on Secretary Cusi and his erring subordinates to immediately resign. With all that has happened, the Filipino people can no longer trust you to faithfully safeguard our country's precious energy resources. I call on the Ombudsman and the Civil Service Commission to promptly file administrative charges and criminal cases against Secretary Alfonso Cusi, who approved the deal, and other DOE officials who evaluated the Chevron-UC Malampaya deal and recommended its approval.
As for Cusi, he says he will issue his response once he gets a hold of the Senate resolution. Udena, meanwhile, maintained there was nothing wrong with the deal and being a private undertaking. It says it did not need the DOE's approval. Now, the Philippine economy may have grown faster than expected in 2021, but the Financial Stability Coordination Council warns there are still several risks posing challenges to this year's prospects. Juan de Guzman reports.
In travel, Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says it's a good thing economic growth outperformed expectations last year because there is a host of risks facing the economy this 2022.
A few days ago, Q4 2021 year-on-year growth was reported to be at 7.7%, putting the full-year expansion at 5.6%. This is a remarkable turnaround from what we experienced in the first year of COVID-19. With this pandemic has been a heavy burden, it has provided us the opportunity to come together and take collective action. Now that we have our growth momentum back, we can pause to take the opportunity to learn from this crisis.
On Wednesday, the Financial Stability Coordination Council released its latest financial stability report, which highlights the risks the Interagency Council has been monitoring and what it suggests to mitigate them. COVID-19 mutations, global supply chain disruptions, and climate change were among the risks discussed in the report. One risk that stood out was found in a simulation by the Office of Systemic Risk Management, which showed the economy would not return to pre-pandemic growth trends, at least not anytime soon. There is another risk on the FSCC's radar that could affect growth moving forward, understated poverty numbers. The latest data from government show poverty incidence was at 23.7% in the first half of 2021. That translates to 26.14 million poor Filipinos. An SWS survey, meanwhile, shows self-rated poverty has somewhat been improving back toward 2019 levels. But the FSCC says these numbers may not fully reflect the widening gap between the haves and have-nots, and the vulnerable will likely take longer to recover from the ill effects of the pandemic and could even go unmonitored by conventionally available data.
The COVID has been an uneven shock affecting those who were vulnerable to begin with the most. And to address that particular concern, there is a issue of social safety net in terms of public health would be the number one concern. But more than just the public health issue, the longer term concern is one of income, savings, purchasing power. And that is something that we will have to think about, because it does affect how the economy will move forward, and particularly how households, or how targeted households, will traverse through the challenges ahead.
The FSCC is an interagency council chaired by the Central Bank and made up of the Department of Finance, the Securities and Exchange Commission, the Insurance Commission, and the Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation. It convenes quarterly to identify possible systemic risks to the Philippine financial system and to recommend measures to mitigate those risks. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.